Welcome back. My name is Everest, and we are going to be jumping into the knife round here for this third and final map. Liquid and Luminosity trying to find a winner here. Very, very, very long series so far. Liquid taking each team taking their opponent's map. So Liquid taking Luminosity's map of choice, and Luminosity obviously doing the opposite and taking theirs back, both in overtime. So really, really close game so far. And this is going to be an important knife round, as we are going to see Luminosity. Looks like they might close this one out. Yep, and Andrean all by himself is going to get taken out as he's up on top of Fur's head. So they're going to get their side of choice. We're going to see what they decide to do here for this knife round. Off the bat, I see they seem to be discussing it, and I guess they're going to stay. I must have done it in team chat where I can't see it. But it looks like they're going to stay on the CT side. So Dust 2, definitely a map different than what we just saw on Inferno and Overpass. Dust 2 is a map where it's a little more free roaming, a lot more T-side, working in to try and find picks, mid to B pushes, stuff like that. Whereas Inferno, very, very strat-oriented, and the same for Overpass, a lot of fakes coming out. And in that regard, having that close kind of middle connector, it is very easy for you to throw a fake to one side on Overpass. Not as easy to exactly fake anyone out on this map, but we will be getting to this one shortly, just waiting for the pistol round to begin here. As we are waiting to get into this one. My good friend Chad has returned here, and we will be going live here in a second, waiting for Luminosity to ready up and start this pistol round off. Chad, welcome back, my friend. Luminosity took the knife round, and they have elected to stay on the CT side here going into this last map of the series.
All right, and honestly, I have no idea how this is going to go. Dust 2 is such a map where if you have firepower on your squad, it can really go either way. And both these teams are fully capable. Again, Nitro, Hiko, Elite, all of these players fully capable of doing amazing things. And Dust 2, we'll see if they can do it here, as Luminosity going to try and hold off this B-side Plague Hold. Will be the first one to find a frag here. Steel can't find anything. Excellent shot there from Nitro. Again, he's been having a pretty big series himself, but they are down a player with the B-bomb site in their control.
And you can see as Cold was coming in there, he got things down to 1 HP, but Fur with 2 big kills, and it's going to be down to Nitro in the back of sight, not able to get anything going from. He silences that player with the 1 HP, but they get the defuse, or they get the plant for Liquid side, and now they have a chance to go forward. We'll see if they decide to either force up pistols, force up a scout. This is a very, very common map where you'll see multiple scouts come out from the ecoing team.
Indeed is. Going to find out in a moment here what they decide to equip themselves with, and looks like it's going to be a pretty disciplined play here. They got the plant in the first, so 5 flashes. Well, they definitely wanted to blind some CTs. We'll see in what real estate that occurs. As a flood towards top middle, you saw from the CT side, weary of a long push, so sending 3 there immediately and then falling off. Definitely a good way to go about it. But because of this kind of play, there's no one on catwalk, but they do have long control. So we'll see. It's going to come down to Fallen with his scout in hand. Does tag up 1. That's a Dren, as they're going to be able to make it on over. Fur with 2, though. Bolt's going to be rotating up from CT ramp, and it's only a Liege, and he can't get the bomb down. 5 players left up for the CT side.
And that's going to be good for Luminosity going forward, as they're going to want to try and get themselves some good utility on this round, as we can see that Liquid is going to go ahead and go for the buy. They're going to nade themselves up, and this is going to be a very important round going either way on this one. You're going to be ecoing if you're Liquid, if you don't connect this round. And likewise for Luminosity, if you want to buy next round, it's not going to be a very healthy one. And right now, Liquid just looking for that mid control. No smoke actually towards doors, so this kind of kind of interesting here. They're going to pop Flash themselves in a leash. Unfortunately, his teammate's Flash is going to catch him there. He's a player beating from CT, and there is going to be a pop Flash coming out here, and it's going to be Cold going down. Early Nitro entering, and he's going to get a second on that player that comes through the smoke, and Steel trying to sneak his way through the smoke, and he comes out. He's going to get one. Can he get any more than that? He drops the bomb and drops a leash down to 2 HP. He comes back through with the pistol, man, and picks up Fugly as well. So huge play right there from Steel, and it's going to be now on Just Fur. And that Molly, he's going to try and come through. He gets the first kill. He's got another one. NCT, he tries to get that one. He's going to get that one as well. And it's all on Adren, but Adren lines up the headshot, takes him out, and that is what you want to see if you're Liquid, getting that quick early buy-in and taking the round.
An excellent work there from Adren in that one-on-one, and that, of course, worrisome that he loses his teammates, but he positions himself in a way that it doesn't really give that one-on-one opportunity. It still is a bit of a trade, as he was posted up in window, and, well, again, could have maybe guessed it, but it was an excellent shot from Adren. Great work from the in-game leader of Team Liquid as Luminosity Eco Territory. Case of the saves here. Not something you ever want to find yourselves with, Fallen. He's going to be inside of Lower Dark. Aggressive play. The downside, Liquid, they're already moving up long. Eh? They smoke the cross. Cold will find a 1D, so that's not too bad at all. And actually, second one here, Fallen, is going to pick up a frag. So three players left up with the control of a bomb site for Liquid.
Yeah, and we have that plant coming in for them. And Adren just hanging out on site. Two players have been lost for them, as we stated in this round. And it's going to be on the defense here. Adren needs to get one or two early. He's going to get the player that boosts up. And there's Hiko getting one of his own before Cold connects another one Deagle. And he's going to be pushing onto site. They don't have a kit. Oh, he's going to get another one. It's going to be all on Nitro. And they're going to get him. And it looks like they are just barely going to have enough time to defuse. I feel like, I think. Yep. Wow. Just barely. Milliseconds. Just look. 0.02.
That
0.02 seconds.
So close.
If he even thought about defusing any later.
Man, I wonder if there was a 15 second defuse, would your voice go higher there?
It's a good thing there isn't.
Right? It's a good thing.
You don't want to hear my voice go to that range. That octave right there, that's going to hurt some people's ears.
Oh, man. Again, that was a full 10 seconds of fuse. And, oh boy, Luminosity lining up these players towards long. Fur actually on the reload, but doesn't make a difference, apparently, as he's going to tap away into Adren. 4K for Fur. What a brutal performance there from him, in a good way, that is. He's 11-0-1 at the moment in Liquid. Again, they do have that one round of the board, and again, they definitely have the firepower to make it work on this map, but T-side thus far, just haven't been able to hit their stride just yet.
Yeah, we're going to see him coming in with another eco here. Only set of armor coming in on Fugly.
You can see a couple of smokes here. He's going to go into Lower Dark. They're going to be jumping right into
him. Oh, Fugly comes up with a huge jump and kill there. Like, he's just maybe someone spot him coming to mid. I don't know what happened right there, but Fugly just destroyed him in there, but it's going to be Steel picking up two before Fugly gets his second on the round with that AK that he has recovered, and they're going to be flooding into the B-bomb site. There's going to be a player in the back of sight to try and defend. It's going to be Cold. He's going to spray down. Fawn is in support, picks up one of his own, and it's a lot of damage coming through. Cold finally finishing off that player out tunnels, and Fallen getting the op frag, but Fugly, man, he just drops off the top of the steps and just, boom, dead.
Yeah, no, that was some incredible stuff. Fur, he did smoke to Xbox, and then it allowed him to get into Lower Dark, and thought he had an opportunity. And Steel, again, big reason why they won the round. He pushed into Upper Dark after that whole engagement happened, drops the bomb carrier, and takes down two before being dropped. So round seven, though, underway. Adren with his AWP, and see what happens here. Steel actually receiving a bit of nade damage. It's going to be courtesy of Fugly here in Upper Dark, Liege, and Lower Tunnels. See Luminosity there playing fairly close to the double doors. Cold for the sport here of Bolton. Liege could probably imagine the way that just kind of dropped on the ground. Again, that was a right click. It definitely see the trajectory. So with that intel, where do they decide to go here? Fur pushed up onto his smoke at long A, and see if he decides to get aggressive, or looks like just dropping that incendiary and falling off. But Liquid still with a lot of options here. But heading back, looks like towards Long A potentially. With players towards Cat as well.
And they're going to have to deal with Fur over in this corner and the op in Fallen on the corner, peeking into double doors. So there's the first kill. Nitro not able to entry in. And Fur is in a great spot, and he's going to get the kill, dropping the bomb. And it's going to be on this player coming out Long and Hiko. Last one left up. Fallen's going to get one of the players coming up Cat. Hiko needs to find Fur in this corner and get the bomb up to site for his team. 19 seconds left. He's not going to get the kill, and Fugly isn't able to do anything either. And a very, very early pause here, and that's what you like to see. Liquid pausing so they can make an adjustment early before it's too late in this half.
Look at the monetary situation here, and I think that's part of it, as Luminosity really running away in that regard. Can see 12,000 on cold. Everybody else kind of approaching 10K as well. Steel, the only one. Not quite, but again, they do confirm it is a tactical pause. Looks like we're actually going to get a double op look here, cold and fallen. Whereas it's interesting to me when we see these pauses come in when there's more than likely not going to be a buy in this round. And I've talked to Laser about it before, and he's, even being like in the environment previously, he's a little perplexed by it as well. What do you think, because this that they're talking about is probably their next rifle round strategy, mm-hmm. you would imagine, but the eco round is still about to follow, in theory.
I think generally the general idea is tactically, one, you can kind of discuss what you want to do for the eco round first, see to get as much maximum damage, which you think will work as well.
Right.
And plus it also gives you that extra round as almost a tactical advantage to where the other team, thinking about what you're doing, has to wait another round before they
right.
actually figure out what you're going to do. So in that case, it can work that in that direction. And it also gives you a lot of time to kind of figure out, maybe test what direction you want to go in on this eco round. You might be able to see if we send one person here, maybe next round there's going to be four people there, you know, but they just want to send that one player there to see what kind of contention they're going to run into like that. So maybe kind of the idea, maybe like a little test round or just to think about what you're going to do for that, for the eco, and then to put some spacing in between that and that really tactical thought on round you're putting together.
So, and that's a great way to put it, as of course, they are going to invest a little bit at this point, like I've been highlighting here. They've got four rounds worth of loss bonus. So even if they lose this, they'll have five rounds worth of loss bonus. And as long as you're hovering around 2,000 and a bit, well, should be enough for a healthy buy moving into that next round. But Liquid, they would love to be able to, like you'd say, at least do significant damage on this eco round and start grinding away at that ever so large CT side economy, rather. We'll see if this is going to work out. Looks like it is just going to be a bit of a B-side rush. Steel will be there, though, as he sprays down four before being dropped. Cold to follow it onto a Liege. And, well, I don't think that was the result they were looking for in the form of making things expensive, but maybe this rifle round strategy will bring them some success. Excuse me.
And we're going to see on this round, unless Hiko opts, no, he's not going to. I was going to say, unless Hiko opts a Dren, we're going to see a five rifle setup. They had the money for the op, but they're going to opt to go without it for this round and get as much utility as possible for themselves. And so far, they are getting aggressive in mid, and look at this. Liege already threw that smoke. He's going to spot that player in CT. Doesn't connect off the bat, but there is Nitro in return. They're going to spot that player in window. Fugly's going to get that other player in B, but Fallen is able to get one as well as Cold, and it's going to be down to Fallen by himself. So that thought out round working for now as they are getting the bomb in sight, and tactically it has worked out for him.
Unless Fallen has something to say about it. This man is ridiculous as he takes down
something
Hiko
else
in middle. But Fugly and Adren, they got a lot to show for themselves as well, as they do have the B-bomb site under their control. Again, Fallen is looking for it. I imagine if someone peeked him from window fairly early here, he would decide to actually further this 1v1. But if it doesn't happen, again, we can hear the bomb is getting closer and closer to ticking away. It does make it very expensive, and we'll get out of there. So, yeah, really good work done by their Fallen. But Team Liquid as well. Great work on the adjustment. Kind of sprinting out middle, catching CT's off guard, and they get their second round.
And because they were able to get the ball plan in, they're going to have plenty of money to buy this round. Not going to have the op if they wanted. Adren had picked up at the end of the round. He wasn't able to exit, was picked up by Fallen. And just to point out what Fallen did, even though he was by himself and those were exit kills, it limits what Liquid can do in this next round. It limits their economy, and it limits that op that Adren had recovered as well. So That aggressive play out mid worked out for Liquid. We're going to see what they do. They have gotten that first round, but this one is also equally as important because if they don't pick up this round, it is going to reset their money and put them in a very, very tough situation going forward.
Nico getting some damage down on the fur here, as you got to know if you look at any videos of or demos of Luminosity or Fur, just such an impressive long A player. But Hiko, that is a hell of an opponent as well that he's faced up against. Hiko actually will fall off, grouping up with his teammate, and it's going to be Cold landing. Knob Shot finds a second one as well as they're trying to split double doors, or rather middle to B. Cold will take down another as trying to breach into the bomb site. Hiko, though, again, Clutch Master takes down two. And he's going to try and find more before getting the bomb down. And, of course, this is very integral if he wants to actually clutch the round. Hoping for someone to peek him here. Looks away right at the moment that Fallen peeks out. And that'll be that. Liquid drop the round after winning one.
That was really impressive for Hiko to get in there and get those kills. He, unfortunately for him, wasn't able to clean it all the way up. Very, very close. Maybe if he would have peeked down and saw that player coming up the ramp towards B and killed that guy, it would have been much, much closer for him. And then his unfortunate timing on that player that came through window also did not help.
Oh, my God.
Poor Hiko there. He's like, I'm going to go out long, guys. Right. Watch this. Gets hit with like 75 bullets and three grenades.
Yeah.
He's already gone. But already coming up, Cat is going to be Liquid, and they're going to lose just about everyone real quick. Fast and easy, Hiko. In the words of Raheem, clean and easy.
Clean and easy, as we got the monetary situation out of control for the CT side. Three players above 10K. Fur on seven. We'll have a buy coming in for the T side. Adren picks up a scout, Fugly, with an AWP. He's going to try and pick the cross here, so it seems, but it's actually going to be Fallen lurking on out, and this is very dangerous as Fallen just oh so consistent, but it'll be Adren actually, and a Liege. Very nice shots from them. Fallen will pick up one frag, but Adren hunting for him with the scout again. Very impressive with that first shot. He's going to peek up, just missing the tag there. Fallen trying to get out of that situation, but here comes Bolts. He is going to try and spoil the plants. He drops the bomb and T-spawn. And that is not a good situation at all. Bolts actually will forfeit it. That's going to create a 3-on-3 where Liquid, they have no idea if Bolts is still around.
Yeah, and that is a smart play on Bolts. He drops the bomb, but instead of putting himself and isolating himself away from his teammates, he falls all the way back to where he can just defend the bomb sites, and it's going to limit the time that Liquid has in basically everywhere from where Bolts killed that bomb carrier to the bomb site. Liquid has to clear out, and they're opting to go the opposite direction right now. But look at this. Cold is going to kill. Oh, the no-scope from Fugly. He picks it up. What? He just picks up the no-scope and just... You got to be upset if you're Fur right now.
That is for certain. Bolt's going to go down to a Liege. It's Fallen, 1v3, and unfortunately doesn't get the kill onto a Liege. Going to get the bomb set here in Fallen. Similar situation to previous when he was in a 1vx. Going to look to make this as expensive as possible. Or, you know what, finds the quick frags. Would be willing to go for the clutch. First one, Liege goes down. Fugly working towards the tunnels, and no tap as of yet. Fallen get a peek out here, and oh, just spots barely them jumping around the corner, and he is going to go for the tap. This is where Fugly comes on out to play. Fallen expecting someone to be flanking him, but Fugly missing that shot allows Fallen to get out of there, and he will be able to... No, actually, he'll die. That he just barely made it out alive, but... to be fair, it doesn't really matter with the amount of economy. And with two rounds remaining, they should still got 6K on three players. Should be able to buy.
Yeah, they'll be able to get a good buy here next round. They'll have enough. Maybe not to get everything they want with steel being very poor, but enough to get by in the next round if they're not able to clean up this round. Aggressive long play from Liquid. Oh, Adren almost has the connection. He gets it on the second try on Fallen, so the Opera is out of the equation. At least one of them. Fur has recovered that off, and Cold has one of his own, so still a lot to do for Liquid in this round. The smoke's going to come out. If he waits, just, oh, if Fur, very patient there on that corner. He smokes it out, and instead of peeking and trying to find something, he just waits. And he knows Adrenaline is going to be posted up trying to get that spam on him, and it's not going to happen for him just there, as we see that Liquid is going to be moving towards A site. Two picks, one out long from Nitro, and one up Cat from Allege is going to clean up this site and allow him to get in here and possibly secure this round. And it looks like Steel and Cold are going to go ahead and save so they can have that comfortable buy in the next round.
Yep, indeed, as Bolts kind of got caught out of position. He looked like he wanted to take a bit of control towards Catwalk. Got caught kind of switching his weapon, though, and went to actually take the duel, did lose it. And like you suggested, Steel and Cold just going to save and make it to the next round. Again, considering they've got money on three players, they will be able to get a nice buy coming into this next one. But this is exactly what we need to see here from Liquid, as didn't actually recognize Cold. Peeking towards T-Spawn, takes down Nitro. It looks like they will be able to, again, survive through the round. So, like I was attempting to say there, Liquid, this is what they require, as Dust 2, it's not too favored to either side. So they want to finish as close as possible, and best case scenario now is 9-6.
Yeah, and I don't know if you saw what I was watching. I was watching some exciting Counter-Strike at the end of the round. Allege shooting the AWP on the ground and pit.
Oh, yeah.
Real exciting Counter-Strike. But, alas, into the next round. We're going to have two ops per side here. Fugly with one, Adren with the other on the T side. Fallen, and of course, Cold with the other op on the CT side. A little bit slower than the last couple rounds. Aggressing into areas for Liquid. Not taking fast and long control this time. And getting that early pick. Hiko is going to be holding it for his team. Right now, Liquid, last round they were able to advance a Cat.
Hiko
with the headshot, getting that player out at long, and they're going to have three players there, and it looks like this is where they're going to show their hand and come out long. They still have two players that come up Cat here, and it's going to be Allege leading the way for them. Let's see what they can do entering in here. Ooh, Fallen gets a nice shot. He's going to drop off and get out. Let's see what Liquid can do trying to get in a return here.
Yeah, Allege makes that up on the catwalk. We can see Bold spams down onto Allege. Nice recoil control doing so. Molotov, though, will force Bolts out in the open, but he still gets one. Nitro and Adren combine to create a two-on-two, though. And Steel, quick to respond on the scene. Cold going to be holding the ankle, but Adren finds him through the side of the smoke. What an impressive play as Nitro spots Steel in the smoke as well. And that's going to be the fifth round for Liquid as they bring it back. Now one away from that sixth round goal they were looking for.
It's going to damage the economy here for Luminosity. We're going to see a Famas coming out and very, very little utility. Not even any armor on Fallen. So he's going to jump across to see if he can find something up towards Cat. Not seeing anything just as of yet. And right now, Liquid looking really good to bring these rounds home. I mean, they need this one right now if they want to have a successful second half. 9-6s. You want to have a minimum, usually, of six rounds on your T side.
As Allege trying to find some spam through here. It's Fallen. Finds Nitro through the door headshot. As I'm sure that was a pretty one. Cold close to mid double doors. Allege looking like he wants to push through, provided Popflash was his teammate, but shrouded in the smoke is Cold. He's just biding his time. They're going to waltz right past him. He's going to get the... That was actually Allege taking down Adren. Enough damage dealt, and then...
No kill for you.
Yeah, exactly. Stealing away that money he would have gotten. But they're going to try and march into B. Steel. If he can spot the barrel here of Fugly, indeed he does. Going to start to spray it down, but Allege will capitalize. Trades, and now they're in B.
And they are going to have a player in Fur trying to come through that molly. He's going to take a ton of damage. Allege hops across that molly. He's going to get that plane. He's going to have to wait for his teammates to cover him. And Hiko. So Hiko's going to pick up the one. Still challenging on the window is Bolts. And that flank is coming through Tunnel. Allege moving to a little bit safer plant spot. Bolts just trying to hold the peak off or the plant off here.
So Allege, Hiko, definitely a winning combination. Has Fallen fully white screen. Bolts tries to make it through the door itself. Fallen will connect, and now it's only Allege as he goes for the crouch peak. Will drop Bolts now. Only Fallen as with that off. Can't hit the shot. It's Allege that'll have the quad kill to take Liquid's sixth round. 9-6 as incredible work from Liquid to take the pause, reassess, and really bring it back in the half.
Again, they only lost two rounds after that pause. They were able to get in there. Well, technically three because they lost that first eco. But after their first bye after the pause, they only lost two more rounds and were able to close it out. So now looking into the CT side, they need to get this pistol round. Very, very important if they want to win this game. We're going to see what they try and do here. And it looks like they're going to be sending someone fast towards Cat. And it looks like it's just going to be one player and then one player peeking mid. So he's actually going to sneak into underpass. So we'll see what Nitro is able to do with that. He's going to have a player coming in close and bolts. He's just going to be lurking here. He's going to see that smoke on Cat, and it looks like they're trying to sell a little bit of a Cat fake. And there's the first kill for Nitro, opening up for his team.
Very nice frag from him, and gets out of there safely as well. We'll see a Liege taking down one from the pushed up catwalk. Cold with a drive-by, though. And that will create a 3-on-4. Adren still posted up on the catwalk for making it through middle. We'll see where they decide to go with things. They still have some utility on the Luminosity side. Adren will drop a smoke on the catwalk. And he's just waiting for someone to get desperate and rotate through, but he's actually taken down. Nitro and Adren combine to deal the damage. Cold and Steel, they're going to pop flash their way through this catwalk smoke, and this is actually their best opportunity, at least a bomb plant, considering that smoke went down and they didn't provide any defense on the A-bomb site itself. So Steel getting the plant in. Cold going to try and cover.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure why Liquid rotated off. It's going to be two kills coming in for Nitro there, taking out the remaining two players. But I'm not exactly sure why they were rotated completely off A. They were able to punish that player in mid, but I don't really know what intel they got where they all needed to drop into CT. Maybe it was just to play as a team for a retake there, and it ends up panning out for their favor. They do lose, or they don't lose, but they do give up a defuse or a plant. They do give up a plant, not right. A defuse. They are on the CT side. They want those.
Indeed.
They want the fuses.
Definitely.
So they're going to go ahead and get as many rifles on the board as you can. See Fugly with the M4 and Adren and Hiko with the Mosses. P90 and a Liege. And, you know, just hanging on with that little moneymaker in Nitro's hands. And you can see Fallen opting not to save with his team. So he's going to be on the scout here.
And this is something that is fairly common from him, as he doesn't mind actually going with some odd weaponry in the round thereafter. You can see he brings himself to $0, quite literally. Everybody else, again, you can see around 2,000 and such. But furthering the position once they've posted up on catwalk, just kind of posturing towards middle and A. Bolts thinking about peeking from the catwalk area. Adren doesn't spot Bolt's drop, and this is where things get very interesting, as they're actually going to split into B. And we'll go back to Bolt's in just a second here, see if he can capitalize on some rotates. No, he does go down. Fallen, though, can't find a Liege. It's only Steel. And Molotov, Incendiary kept him out, and, well, he will spot a player in lower dark. Hiko does the damage, and Liquid, fantastic anti-eco there, not losing a single player.
Yeah, and that was really scary if you were Liquid right there. They got sandwiched in B site with that split, and somehow they weren't able to connect anything there in for Luminosity's side, and they were able to pick up the round, and we're going to see a force coming in here. All the AKs on the board for Luminosity. Fallen, the only person with that one. He's going to have that P250, obviously the consequences of buying up that scout last round, and we're going to already see a lot of condition, a lot of damage already on these T-side players, and we have to see what Luminosity's game plan is going into this early buy.
There has been spotted a blue bin. You can see Dren and Hiko not happy about it. And they will combine, double peek, and they take him down. Liege up on the catwalk. We'll be behind a smoke here currently as Cold is moving his way on up here, just holding an angle, just in case maybe they get aggressive. And when the smoke does dissipate again, it's in a bit of a headshot angle as well. But pop flash through Liege, fully white screen. It will go down immediately. Nitro trying to stay alive here, but he'll fall as well. 4-on-3 is they will take a player advantage back to even. Hiko to credit for that. And very low here are two of the Luminosity members. Steel getting the plant down.
And Fugly is going to be coming up here trying to find the heads of the Luminosity players. His team's coming from Cat. Hiko picks up one. Fugly does good damage on the next. Hiko picks up the kill there, and it's going to be all on Bolts. 12 HP, no nades over there for Liquid, but they have enough of a team support there to stop it. And the player with one HP, he's going to get the headshot and get the defuse. That's Adrenaline picking that one up. Ninth round there, and that's going to force Luminosity down very low on money. They do get the bomb plant, so they get a little extra cash. But still, we're going to have to see what they try to do here. And it looks like they're going to go with Tech Nines and Armor for a couple players. We'll see if they go all the way. Deagle on Bolts. Yep, and they're going to go ahead and go at least three sets of armor. So they're looking to try and get something out of this round. It should be comfortable to buy in the next. I mean, a little bit low money on Cold and Fur here. But we'll see how it pans out for them going into this round.
As they make their way into Lower Dark. Leaving the bomb in upper Cold. Making sure no one pushes from long. We'll group up towards middle. They do have smoke, a couple flashes, bolts. An aid in hand as well, and looks like we're gonna see smoke go down for CT. Just a middle to B split, pretty straightforward. Adren looking for the spray down. Can't really connect Nitro towards Car. We'll be able to find one Fugly as well, as they're all falling. Fallen. Now last one up, only with a Glock in hand, and gonna try and push through the smoke. Does actually land a headshotter.
A little bit of damage there.
A little damage, yeah, onto Adren, but won't be a frag in the end there. Another nice round from Liquid.
And we're going to be going into the next buy here. And Liquid has established an economy like we saw from Luminosity on the other side. They've established that CT economy, and it's going to allow them to buy in this next round if they don't capitalize on this gun round. Very important round here. Liquid or Luminosity, low on cash. They can force them to an uncomfortable or awkward or no buy at all in the next round. Already fallen, has other ideas, taking out Fugly. So that's going to be the opening that Luminosity is looking for here.
You can see the bomb site B completely open for business. Fallen, going to find a second one. As he wants to push his team to double digits. You can see he's made all this noise towards middle and B. They're certain they can rotate off of A, but that is not entirely the case. As three T's still on catwalk. We're going to see Fallen and Steel heading into the B bomb site that will be flanked eventually. We'll see if they're wise to it, as Elige would be that one there. And Hiko actually taking down Fallen. Elige with the flank. Now the jig is up. They know that the bomb is not at this bomb site. Fur is going to aggressively move into CT spawn, and I like this play.
And this is really smart for him, getting that really aggressive defensive position for his team. And his teammate is going to kind of bait for him and ward him off there from long spraying and doing a little bit of damage. Well, actually not hitting any of those players, taking a little damage himself. Those two players are going to be trying to work up Cat, Hiko, and Elige working in here. One player on site to deal with. Let's see how they deal with this one. And it's going to be really low on time here. If they can even get in here, they get one. Ooh, the nade is going to actually, he's going to team kill himself. And it's going to be all on Hiko. He's going to get one. Not going to get the second, but not enough time to even defuse, even if he wanted to. And that's going to be that round. And Luminosity able to pick up a gun round there, and it's going to be Liquid now going to be a little bit low on money here.
Yeah, Liquid, well, to be fair, after their full buy, they will be low.
After that's what I was going for, that after this round, they'll probably, if they can't convert, will be on an eco.
And the opposite, again, on the first round they win, only one left up. You can see Fur, he doesn't even have armor. So, that's not a situation you really want to find yourself in if the round is lost. Well, going to give Liquid a pretty good chance to close out this map. So considering how the last two maps went, well, if we didn't see overtime here, might actually be a little surprising, as teams have been very neck and neck. And we'll see, with 1:05 left on the clock, some pressure towards catwalk. See Dren posted up on a ramp with his AWP. It's going to be first line of defense here if they do indeed push towards Cat. And we can see Nitro pushing through B tunnels. This is incredible amounts of information that there's no one around in this real estate. So Fugly, he's worried that it still could be middle to B. That's why he's not necessarily rotating. Adren will spot out players. One heading down to CT ramp. And he still gets him. Adren with two on the round. And he's not done yet here, as he's got two coming up from the elbow catwalk area. That's going to be Fallen and Cold here. Another shot whiffed, though, from Adren. Tries to find a new off angle, but we'll get the bomb set, and Nitro goes down. Adren to fall as well, and now a 2-on-2 trying to retake.
Oh, Fugly with the jumping headshot, and it's going to be all down to Fur. He is the player you want in this position. The bomb is planted for him, too. No nades in the hands of Liquid, and he's going to try and come out. He's going to get the first kill, but they're going to have the kit, and Alige actually opted to pistol him out there. That was kind of lucky on his behalf that he was able to connect those headshots right there.
Luck? I don't know about that.
I mean, lucky that with the USP,
bugging you. Everest has 11 rounds.
You trying to squabble, man?
Of course. Okay. We'll have to take this out back after it is Liquid.
In the parking garage?
Exactly. It's a perfect place for it as Liquid, again, one round to their lead. 11 to 10. Adren posted up for the lower dark pick. He finds it. Steel will go down. Adren providing a nade to follow, and that does do a little bit there to Colden. Nice play as you can see, actually, Nitro take down one. Adren steals his kill thereafter. That is going to be now a 2-on-5, only for 1v5. And it doesn't look like they're going to get a lot of economic damage or any in the round.
They just wasted some nades. That's all they got off of them. So for Liquid, they are moving into a good position here. As you can see, Luminosity, they're going to have a buy here, but it's going to be a very low budget buy. They aren't going to have what they want. They're going to have two Galils coming in on Steel and Bolts. Couple of decoys because they had those 50 spots that they wanted to use for themselves there, but are going to have an aggressive play out long. Already pushed up is Steel and his teammate in Fur trying to get up long, and Alige getting the entry, and Liquid doing a very good job at this, getting the first kill in these past few rounds and opening up for his team. Adren gets the shot on the cross, and that bomb is dropped now. Can they connect anymore? There's Adren with the nade getting one, and it's going to be Bolts and Cold left to try and get across and get the bomb down. They do recover it, but there is a player in Adren. He's going to get another one. It's going to be all on Cold. He cleans it up. He's going to do a lot of damage to Alige, but they are both now absolutely lit. 11 HP and 12 HP apiece, but Alige still has two teammates behind him. He is going to get taken out, and Nitro is right on the other side of the smoke trying to find where he's at. Oh, he gets one, but Nitro is there to spray him down and finish off the kill. And that's going to be a 13th round, and we're going to see a pause now coming in from Luminosity.
Almost an absolutely incredible round there from Luminosity. Oh, so close, but we do see a pause coming in for Luminosity. Tactical one as they're down 13 to 10 now, three rounds away from closing out this endurance race of a best of three, as it surely is a battle of attrition. As Liquid, again, three more rounds, and if we take a look at the monetary situation for Luminosity, it is pretty much not good. That's the only way I can really spin it. 2,500 pretty much on all, 3,750 on Cold. And that CT SAT economy, well, you can see Nitro is floating a good chunk. Hiko, 5,800. So, see what they can do here. Luminosity on the Eco, as I would be very surprised if they decided to go for that four spy. But it would have, I guess, if they lose it, four rounds worth of loss bonus. I still think they'll wait for the weaponry.
Mm-hmm.
As if you take a look at the highlight players for Luminosity, Fallen is at 23 frags, Cold with 20. Those are the players here usually used to see, and Adren is really stepping it up on the CT side. He's at 18 frags at the moment, and he's had a lot of op action, and that's one thing that we did highlight early in the series was Fallen so impressive with that op. Adren really needs to rise to the occasion to compete, and, well, doing so now, three rounds to lead as well.
Yeah, and it has been Fallen doing a lot of damage with that weapon, but Adren, especially on this map in particular, we saw it a lot on Overpass. He was able to get those picks in early entries on their CT side into rounds, but this map, especially on this CT side, has really helped his team out, getting a lot of kills, not just one early pick, but defending bomb sites and getting one, two, even three frags at times on players crossing and things like that. So he's been really stepping it up, and as you can see, they're actually going to buy a little bit here, as Fur is going to be down to $1,000. So, I mean, the other players aren't going to go with armor, but he has elected to. He's bringing himself down to 1,000. Steel down to 1,600. So a little bit more than you maybe want to purchase, but they are trying to get themselves a little bit of some damage done here.
Yeah, so unpause. Oop. That's all right. Yeah, that should be resolved as I roll my eyes back. Unpaused. Fantastic. Liquid can three rounds to close this out. Dren, considering his positioning here, looking across towards the B side. Nitro will be leading that charge. And I think they're going to be a little worried about, for example, like a middle to B or something like that. Luminosity has been doing some things similar to that, or exactly like that, to be accurate, as a Dren position towards the mid double doors, looking for a pick here. And again, if they do decide to go middle to B, if a Dren whiffs or gets flashed or drops a SOP at all, well, he is actually going to have Nitro taking a forward position. Nitro's been doing really good. Dren will drop fur, and they're going to have a Liege coming up on the catwalk as well. He is able to capitalize onto one. Cold now all alone, and a flawless victory here. Liquid two away now.
Wow, that was really good from Liquid, and all that stuff that we saw Luminosity buy in that last round to try and get themselves in, it ends up costing them in the pocket for this round. They didn't get anything out of that round. Did they even do any damage? I don't think they did any damage in that round. I think they just all died.
Wow, that was, again, flawless for Liquid, as for and Co. heading towards Long A. They're going to have Steel just waiting in upper. Actually, a nade there. Taking down Fallen a little bit. They're going to leave Fur. Side of Long A. And again, always interested to see he plays CT side Long A as well as the T side here. It's always fun to witness that kind of thing as you kind of can compare and contrast how they play either side. Go. Again, he was the one on the T side kind of fighting it out with Fur. So playing in pit now. He does have the help of Liege. Still 5-on-5, a minute left. Not a lot going on other than the positioning, posturing from Luminosity, looking for, at this point, definitely a split A, but maybe a pivot underway. Unsure at the moment.
And Dren is going to be the first line of defense coming up. Cat here, he is standing up over the top of site. He's going to spot one. He's going to get blinded off as that player drops. He should have a teammate that can be able to cover for him, but that player is going to die. Allegia is already gone. Dren needs to hold steady here, and he's not going to be able to do so. Bolts picks up two, and there's Fallen picking up the third. So this round looking very much like a Luminosity round, and this is the round that they were preparing for during that pause, and you can see that tactical pause really paying off for Luminosity, able to pick it up here. And unless these two players are able to do some economic damage, it will be a flawless round for Luminosity.
As Nitro and Fugly trying to keep their weapons up, Fallen drive by onto Fugly. Nitro, see if he falls victim. Again, he's been pretty on point, specifically with AK, as, again, going back to Inferno, had a lot of entry frags, and oh, there we go, demonstrating exactly what I was trying to highlight. Thank you very much, Nitro. He's definitely one of the impressive fraggers on that lineup. Luminosity, and like you had highlighted, winning that rifle round after the tactical pause. And if we go back to the previous map in Overpass, 7-14, they were down. After that tactical pause, they were able to make things work very well for themselves. So we'll see if this is going to follow the same trend or if Liquid can adapt and won't conquer, if you will, as we go into round 26. Some positioning towards tunnels and top middle for the T side.
And it looks like Bolts, once again, working up Cat with his team. They are trying to get themselves into a good position here up Cat. Three players in that area. Steel's going to be coming up in reserve. Not exactly finding anything as of yet, but they might be trying to get the same kind of look here. These two players towards Long, Fallen with the op in the lead, as well as those players on Cat. Trying to make something happen for Luminosity.
Yep, as it is going to be some catwalk pressure here. Dren is going to be able to take down Bolts. He was looking at a couple of shots before, but not this round. As he takes down two, he goes going to drop Fur as well. And This could indeed be the 15th round here as Cold finally fires back. He gets two as well, but Adren drops him thereafter, and it's going to be Fallen. 1v3, the Magic Man with his sop. He will whiff on a Fugly, and that's going to be the round. 15-11. As now, and one round away, can Liquid close this out? Both sides having such an oppressive series back and forth here.
Yeah, and this is going to be on Liquid to close this one out. They had the last one in position to close this out at 15-12. But they weren't able to do so. In fact, they were at 15 for a while before, and they weren't able to do so. So it's going to see how Luminosity is able to come in here and maybe adjust that one adjustment that they made worked for a round. We'll see if they have something prepared for this round to try and bring it back once more. Liquid will be forced onto an awkward buy, and you'll have to think if they don't win this round, they'll probably save so they can have a full utility round coming up here after, so they can get that full round and lock out the game for themselves. But just as of yet, Luminosity not really deciding on a direction.
You have three players towards middle, two in upper dark. Fugly playing that cheeky spot on top of the boxes and CT spawn. He can actually see through, get that little hole right below his crosshair. And he can also peek up and spot a heck of a lot more. Fallen going to be creeping on out here. And this is going to be very interesting as Fugly is looking for his opportunity. And Fallen, he can't find it. Fugly and Adren combined. It's only going to be three left up here. Both very low. They're going to try and make it into the bomb site as it's only now Steel. And this could be it. Indeed it is. Nitro will be able to find the following two. And 16-11. Team Liquid move on forward.
Yes, yes. That was a very, very exciting best of three there. All the way, we went the distance, two OTs, and double digits for both teams in the third map. Liquid looking really strong once they got into that C-side and CT side, and impressive watching them close that one out.
Yeah, no, indeed. And, of course, we will see now drop into the lower bracket to face off against Games Academy would be, again, Luminosity. So we're going to see how the Brazilians fend against each other. But we are going to take a short break here and get that match set up. So when we return, we will have that lower bracket match. But don't go too far, guys. Again, you're watching the RGN Pro Series here on Azubu.